While geometry seems very intuitive, it's extremely hard to write down in a computer program and to sort of systematically explore different geometries. If I give you two shapes and I ask how similar they are, there's more than one way to answer that question. And especially if you're trying to think of, well, is this airplane wing better or is this airplane wing better? There's a lot of things to consider, and you not only need to understand the geometric aspect, but also the physics aspect. So I'm really excited about the ability of bespoke deep learning algorithms for helping us answer these questions of the design where we have both geometry and physics we need to consider. My research is at the intersection of material science, chemistry, and at this moment, machine learning, and figuring out basically how do we use this amazing power of machine learning for scientific data, where often we have small, extremely diverse data sets. Machine learning is a bit like fuzzy programming. So normally when we write algorithms, we have to literally write out everything the computer is gonna do. But with machine learning, we can actually have data. We can say, okay, here's inputs and here's some outputs, and this is what I want you to sort of emulate. It can learn from that data, so you don't have to explicitly tell the algorithm what to do. It learns it from context. The problem that kind of keeps me up at night, the reason why I actually went into deep learning specifically, which is a subset of machine learning, I wanted to build an algorithm that could learn a better language for articulating and representing geometry, and to use those tools to do design, whether that be at the scale of atoms, so at the atomic scale, or mesoscopic scale for kind of textures and surfaces, or macroscopic scale for like buildings and cities. But basically, I wanted to build a tool that could learn useful representations of geometry that we could use for design. I'm really hoping that by crafting machine learning algorithms that really handle everything we know about scientific data, we can create better tools for thinking. So the model doesn't just make a prediction, it's basically helping us figure out where to go next. So it's helping us build the intuition needed to find those special discoveries that are going to really make an impact, either in technology or medicine, or just in our fundamental understanding of the universe.